We've used the connection debugger to troubleshoot our one-line logic. Now let's take advantage of its other function and configure our one-line colors. I'll open the debugger using the binding issues link at the top of the screen. Note that I've added a couple of extra sources for demonstration here that I will delete when I'm done. I've also added a meter to one of my feeders. Clicking on the source node, I can see that I already have colors configured for my sources, and I do have the option to change the colors here. However, there are other colors that aren't tied to one particular source. To change these, I'll click the Set Colors button. Here I see the four different standard colors. When there is no source or other status on a bus, the inactive color is displayed. Think of this as de-energized bus. When two or more sources are energizing a bus, we'll see the default multi-source color. If you're using a standard red-green color scheme, you would set this to the same color as the rest of your sources. If there's an unknown situation where the engine cannot accurately display the bus state, like a connected device is in communication failure, it will instead show the unknown state color. Finally, if a bus would otherwise be de-energized, say the sources are off or the breakers are open, but a connected meter component is still active, we'll see the unmonitored color. This is to tell us that the bus is energized, but we aren't sure which source is energizing it. Below this, in Advanced Settings, we can fine-tune our multi-source coloring. If we're using a basic color scheme, just using the default is fine. However, if we have multiple utilities and generators with their own colors, maybe we want to have different colors when a utility parallels with another utility versus a generator. To begin, I'll click Add to create a new multi-source condition. Now I can select what colors should be displayed when the other source colors combine. Let's say I want to display violet when all four sources are in parallel. I'll close this window and return to the web HMI, where the change has already taken place. As you can see, my main bus has turned violet because all four sources are energizing it. Also, my feeder breaker has turned yellow because my meter is active, but this breaker is open. In this way, a microgrid system can display different colors whether the network is utility-fed, co-generating, or fully islanded. When creating these configurations, keep in mind that the color configurator is an exact list of active sources. If I only select two of my sources for the violet color, we see the bus return to dark red, the default multi-source color. More realistically, if I wanted to display violet on any parallel combination of utility and generator, I would need to add the same color for red and orange, red and blue, red, orange and blue, orange and pink, and so forth. This concludes the basic usage of the graphics editor to create and configure a one-line diagram. I want to remind you that your diagrams don't stop here. You may want to include switchgear designations, real-time data, or alarm annunciators. We've only covered the minimum to run the one-line engine. Next, we'll look at further customizing your graphics pages for your needs. Until then, thank you.